Lanka. So this is all the information you need to maintain your vehicle in the perfect condition and to make sure that your vehicle runs well for a long time, because we are giving you all the information you need to find out the correct spare parts for your vehicle. So next time someone at the garage or your mechanic is trying to cheat you, you can say, hey, no, wait, I learned on Good Morning Sri Lanka that this is not the correct part, and you will know everything you need to know to check out in those particular parts when it comes to finding out which is the original and which is the duplicate. So now, before the break, we were speaking about something that has to be changed quite often.
Yes.
And that is the oil filter.
Oil filter, yes.
Mr. Alavata. So, okay, let's talk about how you can identify the original and the duplicate. So
this is a genuine oil filter. And this is not OEM, this is substitute. If you can have close look at it. This is genuine, this is substitute. Substitute oil filters, the manufacturers, they have their own colors. They don't need to manufacture this just according to this the out appearance or whatever it is. They have their own brand name, they have their own part numbers, they have their own qualities of this. But this is, these two oil filters are matched to a certain extent, not 100%, I would say to 80%. So, in case of emergency, you can use this. We recommend it.
Okay.
Price is, say, 1/4 of the original. 1/4 of the original.
Okay.
And the lifespan.
It's recommended.
Yes.
Okay.
Lifespan of the filter is half of this, half of the original. If you use this original filter for 10,000 kilometers, you can use this for 5,000 kilometers.
Okay, but it's 1/4 of the price.
1/4 of the price.
Okay, so as a short-term repair, maybe that's okay.
Yes, that's okay.
Okay. Okay.
That's okay. Because the certain specifications are already matched. So, you don't need to worry about.
Okay.
This is OEM, not OEM, this is substitute. OEM filters are very much similar to the genuine.
So, it will, maybe the outer appearance also, it will be the
yes.
same. Okay.
In OEM filters, even the color is similar, everything is similar.
Okay, okay. So, that's a great way to find out. And also, that's a great, good thing to keep in mind, that you can use substitute oil filters at the same time. But there's another part that you mentioned earlier, which can cause a lot of trouble if it breaks down.
Timing belt.
The timing belt.
Timing belt. Usually, the lifespan of a normal timing belt in any Japanese vehicle.
But I'm not very familiar with what a timing belt does, actually.
Yes.
So, we can talk about the function of it first.
you are trying to go into more details, I suppose. That's very technical, highly technical.
Okay, okay.
Anyway,
I will
tell
maybe.
You, timing belt is the belt which rotates the camshaft according to the crankshaft timing. Crankshaft and the camshaft, both shafts are interconnected.
Okay.
They rotate. But to a timing, to a proper timing. So, the belt, the timing belt is the one which connects the crank and the cam shafts.
Okay, okay. So, if someone
you
is into motor
you
mechanics, they understood that.
Yes.
But let's move on to the parts.
So, usually the lifespan of the timing belt is 100,000 kilometers of 5 years, whichever comes first.
Okay.
That's how they specify. In normal Japanese vehicles, there are certain cases where you have to change the timing belt more frequently in certain cases. But generally, timing belts 100,000 kilometers or 5 years, whichever comes first.
Okay.
So, timing belt is very important when you want to replace, because you must go for the genuine, otherwise it will break prematurely. The breakage will cost you a lot. It's not only the timing belt. If it breaks, there are certain other components involved.
Okay.
So, I have two timing belts in my hand. One is genuine, the other one is duplicate. Can you see the difference?
They have the same paper also in there, in the packet
as
well, and they look the same.
It carries the sticker inside, because once it is replaced, you must take that sticker and just write the mileage that you have replaced. At this particular mileage, we have replaced it, and on this particular date.
Okay.
Because that time
the
period.
The sticker, everything is
everything
present.
Is identical.
Okay.
Identical. And this belt, this is a special type of belt, actually, the timing belt. I don't know whether you can clearly see. This is with cogged. This belt, this type is called cogged belt.
Okay.
Cogged. So, without
there's
these cogged.
There's some ridges on it.
Exactly. Without these cogged, you can't maintain the proper timing, otherwise it tends to slip.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the belt. This particular model is called the cog belt. If you take these two belts, outer appearance, the dimensions, everything is identical, but again the weight.
I see.
We always feel the weight.
Mm-hmm.
Original timing belt, genuine timing belt is always lighter.
Lighter?
Lighter.
Okay. I see.
The duplicate one is double the weight.
Double the weight?
Yes.
So then that's something that you can easily find out, right?
To compare the weight, what is the measurement that you have? That's experience.
Mm-hmm.
So in automobile trade, experience goes a long way.
So it's very important to go to someone who is very experienced.
By looking at this belt, even I can't identify which is genuine and which is non-genuine.
Mm-hmm.
Since I know it, I can tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, even I get cheated.
So it's very, very important to go to someone experienced when it comes to the maintenance of your vehicle. So we'll be speaking a bit more about other problems that you might have when it comes to repairing and maintaining your vehicle. So stay with us. We'll be right back on Good Morning. How can you stop yourself from being cheated the next time that you go to repair your vehicle? It's always best to have the best spare parts to keep your vehicle up and running for a long, long time and for the safety of your friends and your family as well. So we have Mr. Lal Alawasu with us. He's sharing with us how you can identify between very common spare parts that most of us would have to replace quite often in our vehicles. But I think what has been a recurring theme is the fact that you have to go to someone experienced. Right, Mr. Alawasu?
Yes. Now, we are going to talk about brakes. Brake is very important as far as the safety is concerned.
Okay.
Your safety, your passengers and the vehicle, then the pedestrians,
mm-hmm.
everything depends on brakes. So even the brake parts, there are duplicate parts. And now you have two sets of brake pads in front of us.
Mm-hmm.
By looking at it, even
I can't recognize
what is genuine and what is non-genuine.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we are basically senior experienced engineers. Even we can't identify.
Mm-hmm.
Because color is not a factor to identify the genuine quality.
Okay.
Surface texture? No way. The weight? No way in this particular case. Because you can't just weigh it and see what is genuine and what is non-genuine. So in brake pads, you must go for the honest supplier.
Is
I always recommend genuine because that's the most honest source.
Yes.
Franchise holder or the authorized dealer franchise holder.
Mm-hmm.
So as far as the brakes are concerned, that's number one. And don't use even OEM. I myself recommend go for the genuine.
And
but
also,
the price difference,
mm-hmm.
if you take the genuine and OEM, 50%.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Half of the price.
Mm-hmm.
If you take the duplicate and the genuine, one fourth.
So people might be tempted.
Yes. But the biggest joke is the pack is almost identical. Almost identical.
And I think you mentioned during the break that even the product number down to that is.
Yes, part number, the color of the pack, everything is identical.
So someone might just be selling you some
exactly. That is with the idea of cheating the customer. They have done it,
mm-hmm.
which is not accepted, which is not done.
Of course.
So buying OEM or substitute knowingly is okay,
mm-hmm.
but unknowingly is very dangerous.
Of course. So I think we've gone through some of the main parts that need to be substituted. And when it comes to brake pads, especially, I'm sure, I mean, that's one of the main things that you should be able to do with your vehicle. You should be able to brake it at the correct instances. So again, experience is the most important thing to look out for, and always go to an experienced mechanic when it comes to the maintenance of your vehicle. But I had a question I wanted to ask you, Lal, about now some people use parts that have been in older vehicles that may have been condemned for certain other reasons, but you can get the parts from those vehicles and then they use those parts in
That's okay, Amaya, depending on the part that you are going to use.
Okay.
Because there are certain parts, it's made out of metal, iron or whatever it is. Mm-hmm. Iron parts, they don't deteriorate.
Yeah, yes.
Unless it is corroded.
Corroded.
Rusted, it's okay. Yeah. The iron is iron. Strength will be there. Mm-hmm. So those parts can be used.
Okay.
But with electronic equipment or with certain other specs, mm-hmm. I don't recommend. I mean, we never recommend to use a timing belt which has been used in some other car.
Okay, right.
That's,
I understand.
That's not done. Even the brake pads, we don't recommend to use used brake pads.
Mm-hmm. Because you don't know how long it's been
exactly,
used, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's not worth to take that risk.
Mm-hmm. Of course, when it's lives at stake,
yes,
of the pedestrians as well as the passengers in the car. And also, are there any certain standards that you can look out for when it comes to, you know, a sticker that's on the product or anything like that?
The genuine parts sold by the franchise holder or the authorized dealer, they carry a small sticker.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's like a kind of watermark.
Okay.
So that is a very good identification
mm-hmm.
to see whether it's that particular watermark. If it is with that watermark or sticker, you are 100% sure about the genuine part.
Mm-hmm.
Even without that sticker, you have genuine parts, which is basically coming from certain other sources.
Okay.
For instance, you can buy that particular part from some other country,
mm-hmm.
some genuine supplier, and you can bring it down at a lesser cost. Accepted.
Alright, so there are different ways you can use. Maybe you should research about it on the internet as well. You can find out. It's best to have all the information at hand before you take the next step. So I think we've given out a lot of good information as well on Good Morning Sri Lanka this morning. Thank you so much, Mr. Arawath, for being with us on the show. It's a real pleasure to have you. And with that, we are going to wrap up Monday's edition of Good Morning Sri Lanka. I'm going to leave you with a song, but we'll see you on tomorrow, Tuesday morning as well, with another great episode. Till then, take care.